Good day, ladies and gentlemen. This is the 14th lecture of the series of lectures related to the RM software for filter design. It is about parallel active switched capacitor circuit or filter synthesis. Here is the content. First, we will give some introductory information, then we'll talk about the decomposition of the transfer function into a form of a sum of partial fractions. Then we will say several words about analog prototype function pre-warping. Then we will say about implementation of the bilinear transform to enter the so-called Z domain, and then that will allow for introduction of the parallel synthesis and description of the cells which will be used. And finally, we will give an example of realization. The analogy between a resistor and a switched capacitor is bringing a specific opportunity for creation resistor-less circuits, which are very convenient for integration and implementation at audio frequencies. Here is a simple explanation of the process which you used. If the switch above is commutated by two sequences of non-overlapping pulses shown on the left, the above analogy will be valid when the frequency of commutation is properly larger than the signal frequency, which means that during the steady level of the pulse is short enough that the signal does not change value. Now we go to the decomposition of the transfer function into partial fraction, which is necessary for parallel realization. Here A0 is the nominal gain, N is the order of the filter, while S is the complex frequency. We are still in the S domain, in the frequency domain. Z here is the vector of zeros of length M. M is the order of the numerator. To accomplish this type of synthesis, one has first to represent the transfer function in a form of a sum of partial fractions as above. Here P is the vector of poles and R is the vector of residues, all equal to the parallel synthesis active RC. Here again, after some manipulation, the poles are the conjugated poles are grouped to form a second order cell. As you can see, on the top is the second order, on the bottom is first order cell, which arises when odd order filters are to be synthesized. And what is very important, the second order cell has a real zero, which may be on the left, on the right-hand side, but never it is complex, which means the second order and the first order cell are both have zero gain at infinity. Now here is the bilinear transform. Fs is the sampling frequency. When implemented to the second order cell, we get now this one, which means as now we have complex zeros. And here are the formulae which are allowing to of calculating the new coefficients denoted by the Greek letters alpha, beta, and so on. This the same for the first order cell. And the program SC parallel is creating such this kind of parallel structure where cells 1 to T are related to the sum as shown above, while cell 0 will be a short circuit which will be implemented only in the case where and the order of the filter and the order of the numerator are the same, which means the high pass and band stop filters, of course all pass filters too. Here is the cell, switched capacitor cell of second order, high Q, which is used within the SC parallel software. The same for low Q, so we need two cells only, and we need one cell, which will be this one. And using these two, three cells, we are creating the parallel connection. What we for the example, it will be a sixth order all pass Bessel filter, and the cutoff frequency is chosen to be this number for convenience. These are the zeros and the poles, of course, normalized. And this cell will be used three times. And here are the element the values for the first cell, second cell, third cell element values. There are capacitances. So for the summing, so for the so-called anti-aliasing filter, which is dealing with the repetitive nature of the response of the functions or circuits obtained by bilinear transform, and this it eliminates all the upper copies of the frequency response. It is a low pass filter. SC cascade, SC parallel program uses two such cells, such filters connected in cascade to make the edge sharper or the selectivity sharper to eliminate better the copies of the signal of the frequency. Here is the sample and hold circuit, which is used at the input of the system to create input signal to the summing to the cells. And we will hear the result is in time domain, because there are switches. They have no frequency representation. There are transformations, of course, but they are intermediary. They are not direct. So we will never produce a filter with transformed elements. You will produce filter with switches, and this is why we are using here only time domain to represent the results. And we will give here two responses obtained for the frequency which is 0.5 of the cutoff frequency for delay approximation, and the other one which is at 5 times, which so this is 1 decade, 0.5 times in 1 decade, and we can see that the amplitude is constant, which is all pass filter. One has to have in mind that the spice schematic, which is given by this program SC Parallel, contains switches which in fact are to be substituted by CMOS circuit of various complexities. The simplest one is a single transistor, but one frequently uses very complicated circuit to represent the switches to avoid the transients and the glitches, the spikes which are produced by switches, which are present here. And this simulation is not an easy one. We made a serious effort to accommodate the thresholds of the switches, the on and off resistances, and the rising and falling edges of the pulse trains, so that all functions good enough for the user not to be disturbed when using this software. And the largest part of the spice description is about the switches and timing. A much lesser part is about the circuit elements and the schematic. Note here we are speaking about switched capacitor, which are low frequency circuit, so that the influence of the operational amplifiers here in the frequency domain is not so exposed. But when practical circuits are allowed, one have to have in mind that transients are very fast, and the operational amplifier has to have a very nice slew rate to accommodate to the application. So that would be all about the Parallel Activr SC synthesis. This is an error here, and it's not RC but SC synthesis. Thank you very much for your attention.